Welcome to Shaped by Faith, a special series led by health and fitness expert Teresa Rowe. Get ready for an entertaining and spirit-led adventure while learning ways you can become fit in your body, mind, and spirit. Now here's Teresa.
Hi, I'm Teresa Rowe, and welcome to Shaped by Faith, where we shape our bodies and hearts for God's purposes. I hope you enjoy this full body, low impact workout along with scriptures that will encourage your spirit, mind, and body. You will only need a set of weights, so let's go ahead and get started with the warm up. Go ahead and move side to side. Just move those arms, move your legs. Let's do some hamstring curls. We're warming up the legs. And also the core. Let's go ahead and rotate, warming up the core, the legs, the upper body. Bring those arms up. Submit yourselves, therefore, to God. Listen to this. Resist the devil, and he will flee from you. Bring those arms across. All right, we're almost warmed up here. A few more. Last one. Go ahead and grab a set of weights. You can use whatever you want, and this is a big combo exercise. We're going down into a squat, come up into a hammer curl, press, and triceps, and let's do it all over again. Don't copy the behavior and the customs of this world, but let God transform you, right, into a new person by the way that you think. Lord, help us to be transformed in our thinking. Father, renew us in our mind. We all need to do that every single day. Ask God to renew us. Ask Him to strengthen us as well. Grant us His wisdom and insight, also His understanding. All right, let's do that one more time. And last one. This next one is low impact cardio. You definitely could bring it up. Just cross, elbow to the knee, and then modify jack. And that's it. Elbow, knee, and then modify jack or full jack. Humble yourselves, therefore, before the Lord. And His word says that He will exalt you. He will lift you up. You don't have to worry about that. All right, keep going. Low impact here. And again, elbow, knee, pull that belly in, and then low jack, and just continue. You just want to increase your heart rate. And again, you can jump it, you can move it faster, and bring the elbows to the knee across, and then jumping jack. All right, very nice. This next one, let's just go out into a plank. So make your way down to the floor. Bring those arms out there. Bring those legs back and hold. Now you can go down on the knees if you want to. Present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your spiritual worship, right? Whatever we're doing in your body, in your thoughts, the way you eat, the way you drink. We've talked about this. What you read, what you watch, what you allow yourself to do. Let it be a holy sacrifice unto the Lord. Let it be pleasing to Him. All right, we're working on core strength here. And of course, the upper body and the lower body. And I love the plank, actually. It just feels good. And it also feels like it's a great stretch for the spine. All right, let's come out of it. We're going back up to the strength training, squat and hammer. So set your feet for a squat. So let's go down and hammer, press triceps over the head and just continue that. Just breathe, go at your own pace and your level. If any of you wants to be my follower, you must give up your own way. Take up your cross daily and follow me. And you know, the Lord says, come follow me. Go this way. Go this direction. I am the way and the truth and the life, right? So if we're going to be followers of anyone, let's follow Jesus Christ. How's this feel through your shoulders, triceps, and legs? Last one, let's go back to that low impact cardio. So, elbow, knee, bring them across, two modified jacks. And let's do that again. Again, you can hop, you can jump, you can bring it to your level, whatever that is. Lord, I know that people's lives are not their own. It is not for them to direct their own steps, right? Let the Lord direct your steps and just ask Him for direction. Trust in Him. Bring the elbow to the knee. Heart rate's going up a little. I can feel mine going up, even with this low impact. And I can tell by the way I'm breathing. Reach those arms up there. Elbow, knee. All right, one more jack. Last one. Let's go back out in that plank. So make your way down to the floor. Bring the arms out, legs back, core engaged. Those who know your name, they put their trust in you. Oh Lord, you've not forsaken those who seek you. The Lord never, ever abandons us or leaves us. I mean, He knows that we make mistakes from time to time, and He's right there to lift us right back up. So you keep going. You keep going strong. Don't beat yourself up. Get up and keep moving. All right, that core is strong. Feel this in the shoulders also. In that upper body, in that lower body, just holding and breathing. You are doing so good today. All right, a few more seconds here. Let's come out of the plank. You did great. So coming up next, we will continue strengthening our bodies on Shaped by Faith. For this next exercise, we're going to be alternating lunges. So go ahead and step front, bring the arms out, and then front. Alternate those legs. So you're bringing one leg out, and you're alternating those arms as well. Don't just listen to God's word. You must do what it says, right? So practice the word of God. Whatever you're reading, just ask the Lord how you can incorporate and activate His word into your life. Again, front lunge, landing the heel, and then power back out of your heel as you come back. Keep that core engaged. One more. Nice. All right, this next one's a two-step. So you're going two-step, alternating the knees and the arms. It's low impact. If you want to bring it up, you can do that shuffle step. Whatever's good for you today, right? I love this scripture verse. He must increase, but I must decrease. More of Jesus and less of me. So placing again your thoughts on Him and reading the word and praying, all of those things help us. And also surrounding yourself with people who love the Lord, who will encourage you and spur you on, and you do the same for them, right? All of that helps us just to keep our focus on God. One more. Very nice. We're going down to the floor. This next one is a side plank. And you can keep it low, and we've done this before, on the knee, or you can step out. This is a basic arm row. If you just want to hold the plank right here, that's fine too. If anyone is in Christ, the new creation has come and the old life is gone. Because guess what? The new is here. We start all over again. Isn't that awesome? All right, single row is so good for the shoulders and the mid-back. And that plank, again, you can kneel the plank. You can bring both legs out. and you can just hold it. But I like to do this single row. It's very powerful for the arms. It helps stabilize everything as you hold that core tight. Last one, let's transition to the opposite side. Exact same exercise. Again, you can kneel and bring that arm up, and that's fine. And when you're doing that, stretch that leg out there, so make sure those muscles stay contracted, or go ahead and reach both legs out. You know, if you love the Lord, you show it by doing what He's telling you to do, right? Like as you read the Word, and you want to be obedient to the Word. You want to be obedient to God. You want to please Him. Like the Word says, less of us and more of Christ. All right, feel that again through your shoulders. Feel that stabilization through your core and your legs and that upper body. Last one, very nice job. All right, we're going back up to that front lunge, alternating and using those arms. Front lunge, go ahead, bring the arms out and then bring them front and out and front. Those who belong to Christ Jesus, they've been crucified by the flesh with its passions and desires. I no longer have certain passions and desires that I once had before I asked the Lord into my life. I really don't. And, you know, I was a big sinner, but thank the Lord that He saved me by His grace. I still mess up and I still sin, but I don't have those same desires that I used to, those worldly desires. One more. Very nice. All right, two-step again. Low impact or shuffle step. Bring that leg up. You can flex that foot. And as always, navel to the spine, right? Walk in a manner worthy of the Lord, fully pleasing to Him. And I ask myself, I do, Teresa, does that please the Lord? Does it please God? Would He be happy with you right now? And you know, sometimes I'm like, no, He probably would not. And I have to come to the end of myself and say, Lord, please forgive me for that. And maybe it's go to my husband and say, Robin, I'm sorry. I was tensed up. I was nervous. I shouldn't have said what I said. You know, sometimes we just say things in the heat of the moment. Last one, the good news is God always forgives us. We're going back to a plank. And so bring the legs out or kneel. Now on this one, what I want you to do is take two weights, or you don't have to use weights. You're just gonna row one arm at a time. Bring that elbow straight back. Keep your hips down. Draw near to God. And His Word says that He will draw near to you. Keep Him close. Keep breathing. Keep doing what He's called you to do. Keep pleasing Him. Ask yourself, Jesus is right here with me. Does this please Him? What I just said, does that please Him? My thoughts, my actions, the things I'm watching, the things I'm reading, does it please the Lord? Last one. Very nice. I'm sure that you did those with me and you did fantastic. So coming up next, we will continue strengthening our bodies and hearts for God's purposes. We're working on the biceps with the curtsy squat as well. So let's alternate those legs side to side as we go into those bicep curls. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. You know, that scripture in itself just encourages me. It just lifts my spirit. It reminds me that yes, I can do all things through Christ because He is the one who supplies my strength. I don't have to worry about that. I just have to step out there and do what He's calling me to do. Keep this body strong, keep my spirit strong, read His word, pray, and just really listen to the Lord. Listen to Him closely. How is He speaking to your heart? One more. And now I'm going to switch out the weights on this next one. It's cross jabs. This is low impact cardio. You're just going to bring those arms across the body. You can bring them low. You can certainly bring them way up if you want. You can do a hop on this one if you want it to. But He said to me, "My grace is sufficient for you." Did you hear that? My grace is sufficient for you. For my power is made perfect in weakness, right? We all have weak areas. Just like one side of the body seems just slightly weaker than the other side, well, God comes alongside of us and He strengthens that side. He says, "Here, let me take over in that area." All right, keep it moving. One more each arm. We're making our way down to the floor on this next one. And if you want to use a weight, you can. It's a basic sit up, but then you're gonna rotate. So let's go down, keep the core engaged. Come up, rotate one direction, lower back down, and then rotate the opposite direction. Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God and also believe in me. And that's Jesus. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. All right, that core, it's super strong. It's supporting your spine, your back. Your shoulders are down and that mouth is open. We need a lot of oxygen. Let's do that one more time. Come up, rotate, and make your way back up to the floor. We're going into some reverse lunges. So grabbing some weights, whatever you want to use. Reverse lunge, and you're going to pulse back for your triceps. Reverse lunge and pulse, and then step together. So of course, we're alternating the legs on this one and keeping those arms low. Check your positioning and your alignment. Just make sure you're standing up tall. You're using those muscles. For God so loved the world that He gave His only Son, that whoever believes in Him will not perish, but will have eternal life. That's the good news. I could say that scripture verse for every single exercise and we would be just fine, right? One more. Now going back to those cross jabs. I love incorporating low impact cardio with strength training. Even though the heart rate is not soaring, it's up enough. It's in that aerobic zone. It gives us a great workout. It's something that you could easily do in your own home, just like we're doing now, right? I am the way and the truth and the life. Jesus is. He is the way, the truth, and the life. And no one comes to the Father except through Jesus, right? When we pray to Jesus. He intercedes for each one of us. And He goes to God, His Father. And you'll find that in the Word. So look it up. You don't have to take my word for it. Take God's word for it. One more each arm. Let's go back down to the floor. We're going back to that sit up and rotation. So of course the core is pulled in. I'm going to really focus in on the abdominals here. You know, Jesus told us that in the world, we would have tribulation. You know, we would have some trouble, So he was warning us, he was letting us know. But he goes on to say, but take heart, for I have overcome the world. He has. Keep that in mind when you're looking at the world and you see things going on and you're like, you know, there's no hope. There is a lot of hope through Christ Jesus. One more, and let's go on back up. On this one, we're going back to the curtsy and work those triceps. So go ahead and just bring those arms back and you can kick back. Going into that curtsy, I love this one for the legs. Fear not, for I am with you. This is one of my favorite verses. It just keeps me grounded. Be not dismayed, for I am your God, and I will strengthen you, and I will help you, and I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. I mean, doesn't that just inspire you to keep going? Even when things aren't going so great in your life, God is with you. He's going to hold you up. He's going to strengthen you. That's what His Word says, and I believe it. How's this feel in the legs and through those arms? We're almost there. You're doing beautifully. One more. Nice job. Coming up next, more inspiration on Shaped by Faith. Go ahead and bring the legs out wide for a windmill. This is one of my favorite upper body and lower body exercises. You're going to cross over and then press up. Do the same as you alternate those arms. I am not ashamed of the gospel, for it is the power of God for salvation to everyone who believes, right? So by not being ashamed, you are sharing with others what God has done for you, right? You are going out there among your friends and people maybe you don't even know, and you're giving them hope for a better future. You're pointing them to Jesus in the way that God has given you to do that, right? Everyone is different in their personality, so just be you and point people to Jesus. One more. We're going back to that low impact cardio. So we are going to be doing some low jacks. You can definitely go into higher jacks. So low jacks here, and then a little shuffle step back, and jacks. And again, I'm keeping it low, just shuffling and jacks. And we know that in all things, God works for the good of those, right? Who love Him, who've been called according to His purpose. And again, a little shuffle, keeping that shuffle step low, or you could go two step and then jacks. Now let's do that again. Two step and then jacks. Nice job. Let's go into the side to side lean. So grab the weights that you prefer to use. Bring the legs out wider, pull in the belly. On this, you want to tip into the waist. You want to make sure you're not going front like that. You want to go directly to the side. So you're working the obliques. Those are some major abdominals in the body. They help you to bend and twist and rotate and even lean back. So we want to make sure that these muscles are super strong and they're flexible at the same time. Faith comes from hearing, right? And hearing through the Word of God. So not only hearing someone preach the Word or talk to you about the Word, but you actually reading the Word and hearing it in your heart and in your mind, right, for yourself. So there's a lot of different ways you can hear the Word. You can read the Word and take it in and hear it. You can hear other people's words and as they're preaching or talking. One more. Going back to the windmill press. Go ahead, hinge forward through the hips. That's real important that you do that so you don't strain your back. You want to make sure that core stays pulled in and it's really tight. I will sing to the Lord. Do you sing to the Lord? For He is so good to me. Do you ever go around your home and you just sing? My husband says that I sound like a lounge lizard, but you know, I'm okay with that. I'm still going to sing to the Lord. We love to joke around with each other. He is a very good man, I promise you. All right, keep pressing and extending and feel that stretch as you hinge forward. You can feel that through your hamstring muscles and your hips and your glutes. Feel that press through the shoulders and the lats as you go up. One more each arm. Last one. Going back to that low impact cardio. And for cardio, you could stay here the whole time. You could do your jacks, you could do them low. You could bring them up if you want. You could add a two-step. I think what I'm gonna do with this one is add some knee slams. Just simply bring the knees in front and just tap on top of the quads. Just pulling in that core tight. And you can mix it up. Let's go back to the jacks. Let us offer through Jesus a continual sacrifice of praise, proclaiming our allegiance to Him. Lord, we love You. Lord, we honor You. Lord, we want to please You. Go back to the knee slams, flexing those feet. You're doing so good. Now we're going back to the core. Grab a set of weights and bring the legs out. Going back to that side to side lean. Really lining up the body, making sure that you are leaning into the waist. And like I said, not like tipping to the front. Stay up and stay back. If you cling to your life, you will lose it. But if you give up your life for Jesus, His Word says you will find it. That is so good. Just surrender. Lord, we surrender all to You today. Help us, Father, to surrender every part of ourselves to You. Help us to live a life that is worthy and holy and pleasing to You and You alone. In the name of Jesus, we pray. And they all said, Amen. All right, thank you so much for allowing me in your home today. I hope you're motivated and you continue preparing yourself to be the best you can be. As we continue exercising and praising God together, He will bless our bodies and our hearts for His purposes, because it's God who made us and breathed His Holy Spirit in us so that we can encourage and point others to live for Him. Until next time, friends, may the Lord bless you, keep you safe, healthy, and strong in your body, mind, and spirit.
Tune in next time as we continue shaping bodies and hearts for God's purposes with Teresa Rowe as we all become shaped by faith.